get home, the first thing you have to do after you have your snack is do first your assignment before playing. It's just a structure because you want to teach them later on. These are habits. It's habit forming kasi na they will be able to bring with them when they grow up.
Ms. Dawn says you're enhancing naman yung mga kinahihiligan ng mga anak mo. Meron ba sa kanila na mahihilig din sa showbiz? Litrato, nagpa-picture, nagpa-camera.
Parang ang nakikita ko yung aking daughter, si Aisha, parang...
spread the beauty, diba?
Siguro dahil palagi niya akong pinapanood na nagme-makeup, nag-aayos ng buhok kasi, you know, I work, di ba? Parang na-imbibe na ata niya. Ganon. So, we'll see. I don't encourage it yet. Dahil ang gusto ko kasing gawin ng mga anak namin ngayon, yung mag-aral muna talaga sila. Later on naman, pag nakagraduate na sila, high school, college, they can decide on their own.
How did you realize po that yung multiple intelligence is not just about academics?
When I read up on it, and like for example, sa simple lang na talk that we had also today with Dr. Thomas Armstrong, parang na-enlighten ulit ako. I mean, these are also things that when you think about it, they're very simple. It's very simple education for us parents. Kasi ako, I can relate to it dahil I am a child also of that kind of an era. Remember, I was raised in the 70s. Wala pa pong computer nung mga times na yon. So, talagang na enhance ko talaga lahat ng multiple intelligences ko because I played outdoors, you know, and parang I really was able to explore, you know, na-expose talaga ako ng mabuti.
What is the best thing about being a mom to your kids?
Bukod sa meron kang mga bago nilalang na dinadala sa mundo, I think the best din yun. I think ang the best din as a mom for me is yung makapag-raise ka ng mga bata that can become the best that they can be. That's part of how to you teach them it.
How do you bring up a child in a world like this where there's so much crime? I mean, even as we speak this morning, there was a bombing in Boston, the Boston Marathon. How do you explain things like these to your children?
Yeah, you know, especially my son, who's almost 8 already in October, he's starting to ask a lot of questions. Like, why is there so much violence naman in the world? I don't always try to shield it from them, no? Kasi I believe that that's the real world. That's already the world we live in right now. They cannot also be too ignorant, no, of it. But at the same time, I limit it. I limit the kind naman of violence and ignorance. And exposure to violence, no, the children can have. There's only so much, syempre, at their age na pwede pa nilang ma-absorb, no? So, but the little that I can do, like for example, in the news, you know, in-explain ko sa kanya, there are bad people in this world. You know, that is why I send you to school, and that is why I'm teaching you how to have good habits so that you do not become a bad person. Yung mga simple lang eh, di ba? Mga simple lang na ideas that stick in their minds and to tell them that, you know, there should be more love in this world. You know, that's why I don't like it when you fight with your sister. It's not nice. You're not showing a good example. Mga ganyan. Yun ata importante yun. You know, the children kasi, hindi mo naman sila completely mapoprotect, masishield, no? Because when they go out to school, even with their friends, if their friend has an iPad, they will see violence or anything else that their friends are watching. I think what's important is that when they're at home or when they're with you, is that you really try to impart as much valuable and positive information as you can as a parent. Because a child will always have his parents' voice in his head forever, like I do, you know, kahit nga lola at lolo ko who raised me also, up to now, I still hear their voice of wisdom and reason in my head whenever I am, you know, faced with a challenge, boses pa rin nilang naririnig ko. So, yan, nadidevelop yan sa younger years, itong age nga nila when they're in grade school.